How would that play? Would that
sounds like they've done that a few times earlier today.
I think they're like
a few other people.
We need to get them a little more soft.
They stopped playing their computer solitaire and looked up and started clapping.
You said you just had such a unique perspective on life. You didn't come up with that like out of the blue.
No, he really was playing computer solitaire.
Oh, he was doing it. Dude, put the solitaire down. I thought you were kidding.
I'm really embarrassed, Clay. I'm sorry about that, dude. That was really embarrassing. Let me ask you on the you know the thing called a rider.
Which yes.
you what. Why is it called a rider, by the way? Nobody knows that. All right, well, whatever. The rider that...
Because it rides on the contract, I think.
Okay, I'll go with that. It's a rider. But what do you ask for? And you got to ask for something stupid.
I don't really ask for much. I don't usually ask
for much. Put something stupid in there, though. Like,
oh, yeah, I have Breyers peach ice cream on my rider.
Really?
But that's it.
That's not bad.
That and then, like, apple juice. And, like, I don't like caffeine in my drink, so I have Sprite and whatnot on there, but... That's it. And then the really cool stuff the band has on their rider, and I'm just going
to
steal it.
You need to come up with something like totally like outrageous. Something to make the people at Kiss FM or wherever you're playing work on.
You know, actually go and like they ask for like a certain color carpet in their dressing room.
Do they really?
Yeah.
Who? Name names.
I don't really know, but I've heard. And if I did know, I wouldn't tell you.
You really wouldn't? I love you still.
Because I wouldn't want them telling my mess. I don't want them telling about my Breyers peach ice cream.
So if they walked in and said there's orange carpet in there and they asked for green, they would walk out and leave.
Well, I don't know that
yeah.
I mean, if they don't have ice cream.
You're talking about Ryan Seacrest, right? Yeah, we know.
So,
anyway, whatever. Dude, give me some details. I know you have a Christmas album.
Christmas album that I'm in the studio recording right now, which will be out sometime at the end of the year.
Which track would you like me to sing on? I know we were talking about that. Or is there a rap part you want me to do?
The Little Drummer Boy.
Good times.
All right. So, once again, the details.
Walter Afanasieff is producing the whole thing. So,
okay.
My big name doing that. And we should have it finished within the next few weeks and then into the, you know, to all the whatever they do after I finish my stuff. And then it'll be out in October. And then while they're doing their stuff, I'm going to be on tour this summer. Kind of a lot of places. I think July, August, and most of September.
And you live in L.A. now? How's the L.A. life treating you?
It's okay. It's okay. But my house showed up in Touch Magazine the other day. It ticked me off. I was mad.
So, and they didn't, you didn't know they were shooting
No.
What did they show? They didn't show your address, did
No, they were also nice, because they have morals over at In Touch, apparently.
Yeah.
And they cut off the address itself on the mailbox, but they practically told where it was.
Now, I've been in touch with a lot of your fans, dude, because they call me all the time, you know. They give me suggestions for your album title. The Clay Train is coming, which obviously you didn't use, whatever.
You suggested that, and it was on the list.
All right,
for a
but
minute.
I know they're rabid fans. They're probably trying to sneak backstage right now. I assume they found out where you lived, and they're camped out 24/7.
No, we don't have much camping out going on. They're usually pretty respectful. As far as the house goes, they camp out around my mom's house, though.
Really?
Yeah, if I go home to visit my mom, they know that I'm there. They have people at the airport, I think.
How do they find this stuff out? Is everything on the internet?
Everything. They know everything. They find out things before I do sometimes.
Okay, and how about people sneaking backstage? Have you had any? Because your fans
We did a show at Kiss in Miami. They had two people come backstage and pay $2,000 for fake credentials. And then they got kicked out.
I think for $2,000, you should get real credentials.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Come on now. And then they came back and they had they went out to the merchandise stand and bought a whole bunch of Simple Plan gear and came dressed up like they were Simple Plan groupies so they could sneak back again. So that no one would think they were Clay Aiken fans.
That's creative. I'll give them points for that. Did you talk to them at all? Did you see them?
Well, I did see them.
Did you run or embrace them?
No, I spoke to them.
All right. Well, Clay Aiken, dude, I guess you just got off stage. You caught like the last song, your last song, and then the place went nuts. And nice job, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
What's next for you? You taking off going home? You're going to kick back and watch some of the other artists?
I'm going to finish this album up.
Tonight. You're going to finish the album
tonight? I'll probably stick around for a little bit. No, I won't be finishing it. I'm not that much of a hard worker.
Got it.
And probably I'm going to stick around for a little bit longer, and then I've got to head home. I'm tired.
And then a little break, back to the album.
Back to the album, then I'm going on vacation finally for the first time in, I think, a year.
I would say where, but if you said where, then...
They'd show up.
Yeah, they're going to know anyway, but... Okay. All right. Clay, it's a pleasure, man.
Thank you very much.
You guys, Clay Aiken, it's JoJo on the radio. We are backstage at Wango Tango. Some love for Clay Aiken. Yeah.
Stop playing that computer solitaire and clap.